Hello, my name is Diane, and our topic today is antibody-dependent enhancement in dengue infection. We'll be answering three questions. What is dengue? What do antibodies do? And what's different about antibodies in antibody-dependent enhancement that actually makes the infection worse? So antibodies making the infection worse. To answer the first question, we have with us today the man, or rather the mosquito himself, the man himself, Mr. Mosquito. Don't worry, he doesn't bite. It's only the female mosquito that bites. Thank you for being with us today. Because dengue is a mosquito-borne illness. Oh, he brought some family slideshow. Oh, that's the Aedes aegyptius. The most common vector for dengue transmission. It's also the vector for yellow fever, chikungunya, and Zika. Baby pictures. So, dengue larva is laid in stagnant water. So the big public health problem is clearing up ponds and garbage dumps. And you guys work travel surveys. So the Aedes aegyptius is found in every continent except Antarctica. It's a neglected tropical disease, but it is mostly a problem in developing countries. But if you think that's something we can ignore, let's remember Zika, which is also a flary virus and also transmitted by the same vector, to remind us how easily irrelevant man-made borders can be. Thank you, Mr. Mosquito, but I have my own family slideshow to show now. So this is back in Sri Lanka, which is currently battling the worst recorded outbreak of dengue fever. That's me, and those are my brothers. We're only separated by 1 and 2 years apart, but notice the difference in height. In countries like Sri Lanka with many neglected tropical diseases, usually the child who is starting the cycle of infection, they need to go through the back infection. You expect that person to be the one to get the disease. But it's actually my oldest brother who ended up with a severe case of dengue. Indeed, something about a strong immune response suggests a worse outcome. That's my middle brother. He didn't get dengue. Just ignore him for the example. He's a middle brother, so he's used to being ignored. So what happens if someone like my brother gets dengue? The first is dengue fever, which is known for fever and bone pain. A step above is dengue hemorrhagic fever, which is known for capillary bleed and hemorrhage, which in turn can lead to the worst outcome, dengue shock syndrome. Okay, so let's find out what antibodies normally do before we learn what goes wrong in antibody-dependent enhancement. So this is an antibody. It has variable regions that are specific to an antigen. It's also made by B cells, and it can be in extracellular space, or it can be membrane-bound to the B cell as part of the B cell receptor complex. And to activate the B cell, you need two signals. The first is simply the foreign antigen or virus attaching to the B cell receptor. This is then taken up by endocytosis, present around MHC class II to a T cell, which provides a second signal. And now this specific B cell can multiply and start producing antibody. So a specific antigen and specific antibody can come together to form the immune complex or the antibody-antigen complex. Now there are three effects it has to fight infection. The first is neutralization, where the antibody-antigen complex simply has more antibodies recruited to surround it and block it off from infection. The second is opsonization. So a plain antigen is not very appetizing to a macrophage. But attach an antibody to it, it's so much more palatable. You eat it and digest it. The third trick is complement activation. So you have an antibody. But meet C1, it's evading a circuit, but it likes to have the antibody. It looks innocent, but this leads to a chain reaction. And on the other end, you get things like cell death, lysis, and things like membrane attack complex. So those are the three things the antibodies do. So now, what do antibodies do differently in antibody-dependent enhancement of infection? So now you actually have antibodies making infection worse. So the first reason is dengue comes in different serotypes. This is dengue. You can identify dengue because it likes to wear hats. But some serotypes, there's a different kind of hat, so they all have their own preferred hat. The second reason is dengue infects the macrophages that phagocytize it. So let's run through the normal antibody response again, this time noting the differences. So you form the complex, this time antibody is specific to the top hat variant serotype. And neutralization is specific, so it's effective. Then you have phagocytosis after opsonization. But this is a bad idea, because remember, dengue actually can survive in the macrophage and infect it. So, But you have other mechanisms in place to fight the infection. So you get the first infection, but now your immune system has some memory. And but it's not aware that different stereotypes exist. All it knows is that someone wearing a hat caused a lot of trouble. And then a while later, you can be exposed to the next stereotype. So then that's the third reason. A second dengue infection with a different stereotype or different hat generates a memory antibody response that is large and rapid, but it's actually ineffective at neutralizing the new stereotype. So this is dengue. We can get that this is dengue again because it's wearing a hat. But it's a different stereotype because it's wearing a turban instead of a top hat. So like what might happen to you if you walk into the airline security wearing a turban, you get stopped. because the antibody is generalizing from its previous bad experience to the headwear bad experience. So then we have neutralization. And but it's not as iterative because it's not the exact kind of hat. So you can make detachment but not the neutralization. Then you have opsonization. But remember, dengue actually infects these macrophages. And so memory response, you're having more antibodies causing more macrophages to get infected. So with those things combined, you're having more ineffective antibodies causing increased viremia, and as the macrophages travel around the body, they're spreading the infection. So in summary, you can have a lot of memory antibodies that form antibody-antigen complexes that are not specific because of the new stereotype, and more antibody-antigen complexes that are weakly neutralized because of different stereotypes. And more weakly neutralized antibody-antigen complexes leads to more macrophages getting infected. And more macrophages getting infected leads to the macrophages spreading the viremia and having more severe outcomes. And so that's what antibody-dependent enhancement is. It's antibodies from a first infection responding and binding to a new serotype in a second infection, but are only weakly and ineffective in neutralizing. And this causes increased viral infection of macrophages, which leads to increased viremia and a more severe infection. And that's my job. Thank you.